Time I Die. I got Jordan and Kenny Buckley here. You guys are currently on tour in support of your newest album, From Parts Unknown. You guys just got off a Vans Warped Tour, headlining that. I just saw Revolver, the 20 greatest albums of 2014. You guys are number 10 on that.
Yeah.
The newest album's got such great reviews, both critically acclaimed and fans are seeming to love it. What's been the best part of 2014?
All the stuff you just said.
All that stuff. Besides this interview, what's the best?
The record and the whole fact that people like it. You know.
Yeah.
It would have been a bummer if people didn't like it.
No, it's badass. It's one of my favorite, I think, right behind The Big Dirty. This is my definitely one
you like
of my
that favorites. Best?
For me, yeah.
Okay.
That's my favorite, yeah.
How come?
I don't know, just that one just makes me want to rage whenever I put that in. When I'm driving,
this
better watch
it?
Out.
This new one does it?
Oh, it definitely does, for sure. Absolutely. But that's like the
not
one.
Fast.
Not, yeah.
No, I love it. I'm not saying that. What's the song? Is it More?
Yeah.
I love that song. It's got the slow intro. It's kind of creepy and eerie.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong. I like this one too.
Okay. Just checking.
Yeah.
We got to know what to do better for next time.
No. I love it. What about you? What's the best moment of 2014, Keith?
I really like the fact, I felt really accomplished once the record came out. So we're still kind of riding that wave. You know, this touring cycle isn't nearly over yet. So
yeah,
so a long way to go, and the shows are just getting better and better.
You guys got any planned after this Ghosts Inside tour?
Oh yeah.
Anything you can
divulge? Australia in January, Europe with Architects in February and March.
They're on this bill right now.
Yeah.
They headline over there for that tour though.
Okay.
Yeah.
Will y'all be doing the festival circuit next summer again, probably? Do Soundwave?
I just saw the Ron one.
Okay.
So I'm assuming.
Yeah.
I
guess I'm playing that.
Yeah. It's like, oh cool, I'll be in Europe in July apparently.
Okay. So what's the key to surviving a Warped Tour?
It
seems like a brutal, just sweat.
I don't know if it's really like that hard to survive.
No, it just seems
really
like
not.
It's just hot and just
you have to go.
Brutal.
You have to go out of your way to have a bad time. I think.
Yeah.
So I think that surviving is just. I mean, just take it day to day. It's great. Enjoy it.
Now this is how many Warped Tours does this
five.
Last one make?
Yeah, it's
five full Warped Tours.
Okay. Now Keith, I think I saw something that you're writing a novel. Is that correct?
Yeah, I'm in the editing process right now.
Can you tell us anything about that?
Not yet? Not yet. It's coming out in next winter.
Is it like fiction?
Rare Bird
is
books.
It?
Yeah, it's fictional realism. There's some storyline to it, but it takes elements of touring life.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then Jordan, you have a clothing company as well, right?
I draw a lot. Yeah, and I just kind of put it on stuff. Sometimes it's clothes. I've been doing a lot of posters and prints lately.
Now that's all your original artwork.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
Thanks. Yeah, it's a good way to spend time. It's a good way to kill time. It's a good way to use a talent, I guess, separate from guitar playing and touring and all that stuff. So it keeps me busy. It's fun, kids. Especially with like social media now, it's a really good way to kind of. You know, get involved with people and kind of show them what you do on the side and get feedback. And, you know, without that, I'd just be, you know, drawn in a corner.
Yeah.
And I just not really have anyone to show it to. So, yeah, it's cool. I get to keep busy, put it on clothes, put it on whatever.
What's it like seeing your artwork, fans getting it tattooed, that sort of thing?
That's cool. It is cool, unless it's really bad. I've seen a couple bad ones. I feel
bad
because
the tattooer didn't.
Yeah, because I feel bad just because
didn't translate.
Yeah, a lot of people think that all art is the same. Like they assume that if you can draw, you can tattoo and you can paint, and it's really not. It's like assuming that like someone that plays the guitar can also play the violin because
right.
It's got strings. So a lot of times people take my drawings, which are, I guess, very detailed, and they won't take them to a good enough tattoo artist. But there's nothing better than seeing a really good one, and there's pretty much nothing more awkward than seeing a really
good
one.
You should have to proof the transfer when a tattooist draws it up. They should have to like tweet it to you, and you tell them if it's a good enough transfer.
For sure. That's going to be an awkward conversation. Check out my tattoo, dude.
Because
that's brutal.
There was one guy who got like, and I feel bad. If he's watching this, hopefully he's not. But he got like, I did the cover for New Junk Aesthetic, and he got it like tattooed on his hands, and it's really bad, really bad. And he was just like, can I please get an RT? I couldn't even like retweet his picture because I knew people would just make fun of him. So I just had to ignore his request. It was so, I felt so bad. He went out, he got art that he loved from a band that he loved on his hands. I got like, I couldn't even star the tweet. I couldn't even, art. I was so bad.
But, I imagine if he gets that on his hands, he's got to be watching y'all's interviews.
I love the dedication, and I really appreciate that. But, just, you know, you get what you pay for with a tattoo artist. Just save a couple bucks and take it to a guy that says he can do it.
Yeah, I get that question. Where do you get your tattoos? Yeah. People aren't willing to spend the extra money for a good one. So being brothers, how is the writing process for you guys? Like, what is it? Like, what is your writing relationship for
being sisters, probably?
Yeah, probably not.
Me and Andy, and we write the riffs, and then we bring them to Legs, and then him and Steve, and we just kind of all get the music done, and then we give it to Keith. So Keith's the...
And vocals will be the last thing.
I'm the guy that sits in the basement on the computer while the rest of the guys are recording the record.
Just looking at YouTube.
Plug in lyrics, making sure everything works. Okay. I'm on the last stage of it, so.
Yeah, I saw like a Metallica video where they were like, or a movie or a documentary where they were just all working on lyrics together, and it seems so, we've never been a band that ever did it differently. It's always been music first, vocals and lyrics second, and the vocals and lyrics, it's all Keith, so. Just watching like other bands like sit around and have a little powwow with like their notebooks and ideas, and that was uncomfortable. That was almost as uncomfortable as the guy with the hand tattoos. So I think our method is better. I'm saying we know what we're doing.
You got a good
more
method.
Than Metallica.
We know. We're more efficient than Metallica.
Every time I die, I'm more efficient than Metallica. Yeah. You heard it here.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna get a little personal. What's the most annoying thing about your brother, Jordan? Go.
So far, I love this tour so much that, like, I was thinking about it the other day. I can't find anything to complain about. Normally, I can write our manager and be like, fuck it. Oh, no.
Leave his socks out. What a dick.
Yeah, no, he's really clean and...
I do clean a lot.
Okay.
I always say out the garbage. That would be the thing, too. I throw things out that probably shouldn't get
That might be it. No, but that wasn't even this tour.
Yeah.
I think, like, two tours ago, he threw out my... Buffalo Wild Wings leftovers. That's the last thing I can remember.
Andy still thinks I threw out his iPod.
Yeah,
he probably lost it somewhere though.
Yeah.
What about you, Keith? Annoying trait about Jordan?
It's for being in such a small, confined spot, we don't even really like get on top of each other. I mean, we have two different crews where it's like one person's in the bathroom with the shower in the hotel room with the shower, and the other people are in the van. So I think it used to be just things, just like too much stuff spread, like what you know. Everyone kind of unloads when they get in the hotel room and everybody's luggage and shit's around. But that's not even a case anymore because now he's in one spot and another. So,
If
it was our tour manager, it would be snoring.
Yeah.
Okay, Brian, snoring.
Yeah.
Favorite thing about your brother? Opposite of the spectrum.
Just like I said, it's the same answer. This tour is so fun. I just like... We've had bad tours, I'll be honest. We've had bad tours where kids either don't come or don't stay, or it's cold, it's not fun. This tour is so fun. I'm enjoying every second of everyone's company. It's really awesome.
Awesome.
Even New Mexico, I didn't have a terrible time.
Okay.
Even on a cold Sunday in New Mexico, I was like, you know what? This is better than last time we were in New Mexico, because last time I was in New Mexico, it was my 30th birthday and I was getting spit on by Guar fans. So it seems like every single thing about this tour is better than every tour we've been on.
Okay, cool. Do some like rapid fire questions. Best concert you guys have ever attended as like a fan?
I saw the Hives one time at like this festival in 2005. And that's kind of my go-to. Because I wasn't really into them, but I was kind of into them. And then I just kind of stopped off to watch. And like they made like 100,000 people go fucking ape shit. And they were fucking awesome. So. Nice.
I just saw Kanye West like a few months ago. I thought that was he had a really good production. He had a whole mountain.
Yeah, and that giant LED wall behind the amp.
Yeah. Here's the thing. I don't really enjoy attending concerts. So for that one to keep me.
And he played for 3 hours.
Yeah, for that long, I was like, okay, he's got it. Good.
I saw him in X Games. He was a headliner in Austin for X Games earlier this year.
Yeah.
best show you've ever been a part of? You guys have been on some crazy, insane bills, like all those festival dates. Was there a moment where you got, holy shit, yeah. this is it, we made it?
I'm sure there's been a couple Warped Tours where, you know, you walk off stage and you're just like, oh my God, we're like a real band. Like the kind of shows where like you can't see the end of the crowd, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But then again, like yesterday in Dallas, you know, you got 700 kids packed in a bar going fucking ape shit. So it's just really like what kind of mood you're in, whether you want to be big and outside or small and packed, or yeah, there's no one better than the other.
I like that we played a festival in Europe one time and Portishead was playing and I got to show my pass to watch on stage. And I was like, okay, well, Portishead is like one of my favorite bands of all time, and now I'm on stage because we're playing this festival, so it was great.
That's awesome. Okay, so like favorite movie. You got a favorite movie?
I watched so many movies.
Boy.
This year?
Sure, this year.
Either,
have you seen Gone Girl?
Yeah. That's
don't ruin it, I haven't seen it yet.
Either Start Up, which is this awesome prison movie, or The Raid 2.
Okay.
For this year. Guardians of the Galaxy 3rd. 4th. yeah, just sorry to tell
you. Have you seen Nightcrawler yet?
No, I haven't seen Nightcrawler yet.
It's pretty good. Leaves you feeling awkward, though.
I just watched... The new Sin City is alright. I watch a lot of movies.
Okay. Keith?
I just saw Interstellar like the other day. That was really good. It was a good experience. Because okay. I saw it on IMAX. So, I like that. Yeah, I don't know. I haven't really seen too many movies yet. And I have to make it a point to get out. Because I know that there's so many this year that I need to check out. But I don't even remember. What was that British one? Filth or Shame?
Filth.
Filth was a British one?
Yeah.
Or the Scottish one, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Filth is a good movie.
Okay, so... Besides from Parts Unknown, what's like one of your favorite albums that's come out this year? On that list I saw, mine for me would be Killer Be Killed. Besides,
I haven't heard that yet.
Oh, it's sick. It's got Dillinger Escape Plan,
yeah.
Mastodon.
I knew Attila is really good.
Okay.
What have I just been listening to a lot?
Run the Jewels 2 is really good. I've listened to that.
New Death from Above is really good. That came out this year. I'm going to remember as soon as this interview is over. It's going to bug me. Well, New Ghost Inside just came out. We're on tour with them. That's good. New Architects is really good.
Okay.
Really good.
I'll have to check out those two.
Mm-hmm.
The last thing I like to talk about is tattoos. You guys have like a funny story behind one of your tattoos, or like, I know me and my friends, we have bro tats. You guys got to have some bro tats, right?
I kind of got over, I haven't gotten a new tattoo in like 8 years. And the whole joke tattoo thing, like, it's too painful to ever be worth the... For me, anyway. I'm a wimp. I have to get the spray that numbs you. So, I mean...
What about you, Keith?
We have a mutual friend. His name is Alex Party, and he drew this one picture one time. It was Rocky Dennis's face on Rocky... Rocky Dennis's face with the mask on Rocky Balboa's body, and I don't want to show it to you, but the point is, I was in the bank one time and I had shorts on, and somebody who was in line behind me was like, you got a lot of tattoos. I'm like, yep. And he looks at that door and he goes, is that a picture of your dead friend? And I'm like, yep. So that was funny for me.
There you go. Well, yeah. Thanks so much, guys.
68. Good.
Oh, yeah, 68, yeah.
There you go. You remembered it before the end of the interview.
Yeah.
How do you? Okay, thank cool. You. Well, I'm a photographer as well, so I'll be down there in the pit.
Awesome.
I'll see you guys tonight. Thanks so much, guys.
Thank you.